Hello everyone, you are watching Important Concepts in Financial Derivatives with Ravindra Hegde. Friends, today let us talk about speculation through derivatives. Before we talk about speculation through derivatives, it is very important for anyone to understand what we mean by bullish sentiments. Bullish sentiments are simply expectation of parties, expectation that the price will rise in future. So this all about what you have as an expectation towards the future price. If a party has an expectation that the price will rise in future, then we simply say party has bullish sentiment. And bearish sentiments on the other side indicates an expectation that the price will fall. My friends, I would advise a point of precaution over here where bullish and bearish sentiments should not be misinterpreted as bullish and bearish trends. Trend in the market indicates what has happened in the past till now. That is, trend is all about how the price has moved in the past till this point. And sentiment is about expectation of the price. So trend might be bullish or bearish. Bullish trend means from the past till now, the price has moved upward. And bearish trend means from the past till now, the price has declined. Bullish sentiment is about the expectation of the future price, that the price is expected to move up. And bearish sentiment is about the expectation of the price in the future, that the price is expected to decline. So friends, decisions in the stock market are always made on the basis of sentiments of the investors, not on the basis of trend. Trend can just provide you a supportive guideline. What acts as a major role playing thing is the sentiments of the investors, or sentiment of the parties, so-called hedgers, speculators, and arbitragers. Based on their sentiments, they plan a trade and then execute the same. And what you see, if you have been one of the parties in a forward contract, you might either make a gain or incur a loss. So forward contracts are simply contracts which will bind both the parties, and that binding of both the parties can offer right as well as obligation to perform in the hands of both the parties. So let us do one thing. That example of Mr. A and B, what you have discussed sometime back, we extend the same example in speculation scenario so that we understand speculation through derivatives. So let us go ahead. Mr. A says RH Limited's share quoted rupees 600 now. After 3 months, price will rise. That means we conclude that Mr. A has bullish sentiments. Mr. B says, no chance. After 3 months, the price will fall. That means Mr. B has bearish sentiments. Obviously, both the parties cannot be correct. One of the sentiments will be correct and another will go wrong. Now Mr. A further says, I agree to buy 500 shares of RH Limited at rupees 600 each after 3 months. Because Mr. A believes that the price is going to further rise. He is ready to buy at the current price after 3 months. On the other side, obviously, Mr. B would agree to sell these shares at rupees 600 after 3 months. Because Mr. B believes the price is going to fall from this level. So Mr. A proposes, let us make a deal. Let us make a speculative deal. Let us sign a contract. And B says, we shall square up the price difference in cash. So they sign up a contract and the deal is done. Now what happens afterwards is to be understood. Now this is again a derivative. If after 3 months the price of shares of RH Limited turns to be rupees 590, Mr. A loses rupees 5000 and Mr. B gains rupees 5000. Why 5000? Because the difference of 600 and 590, that comes to rupees 10, multiplied by 500 shares would give a total amount of gain to Mr. B of rupees 5000 and loss to Mr. A of the same amount. So what should happen? Because it is a derivative. It has to be settled by way of price differential in cash. What Mr. A should do? Mr. A should simply pay rupees 5000 to Mr. B. So here comes the claim made by Mr. B. He says, come on man, clear off your due, simply pay rupees 5000. So what is unexpected happening over here? Mr. A denies. He says, do you really think so? Forget it. Now here, in spite of Mr. B making a profit, Mr. A is daring to make a default. And default in the contract, Mr. B simply cannot do anything. He cannot do anything. What to do? Someone may think, yes, Mr. B can definitely go to the court of law. However, for small amount as involved in this case is just rupees 5000, Mr. B may not want to initiate such kind of legal proceedings. So what should be done? How should such defaults be taken care of? People say prevention is better than cure. So what can be done prehand? There are ways. Definitely there are better ways to deal with such a scenario. But this thing you have to plan before you enter into such contract. I will show you how to do a better way to deal with defaults like this. Before signing up the contract, both these parties should have involved an intermediary. So assume that Mr. Ravi has been called upon as an intermediary, and this intermediary says, wait before you sign the contract. Both of you deposit rupees 20,000 each with me. Now both of your deposits are with me. Mr. A's balance is rupees 20,000 and Mr. B's balance is also rupees 20,000. So what happens after 3 months of signing the contract? We have seen Mr. A has lost rupees 5,000 and Mr. B has made a profit of rupees 5,000. And how we have calculated this 5,000, we have already discussed earlier. So Mr. A should pay rupees 5,000 to Mr. B. And this settlement will be much more simplified in this case. What intermediary will do? What Mr. Ravi will do? He simply deduct rupees 5,000 from Mr. A's balance, making it just 15,000, and simply add that 5,000 to Mr. B's balance, making it 25,000. So once a settlement is done, Mr. A will not get back rupees 20,000, but would receive only rupees 15,000, and Mr. B on the other side would receive a total amount of rupees 25,000, which is inclusive of the profit element made in this contract. So the root question now arises is, from where to get such intermediaries? So that is not a problem, my friends. Derivative market is the intermediary for you. Yes, that's why derivative market exists. So simply what you have to do is, you have to approach the derivative market and simply you have to register a trade in your name. You have to decide whether you would want to be a buyer or a seller. And you don't even have to search for a counterparty. No, but the arrangement made through a derivative market will not be a forward contract. It will be a futures contract. So future contract is an upgraded version of the forward contract. So what happens is there will be a particular future contract quoted in the derivative market. Which stock, which will be the date of settlement, what is the quantity, what is the price, everything is quoted over there. What you can do is simply decide whether you want to be a buyer at that quoted price or you want to be a seller at that quoted price. And I am telling you, you don't even have to bother about who is going to be the counterparty, because derivative market as an intermediary will first of all make a guarantee of performance. Secondly, it will ensure that the settlement is taking place when the time comes. So you are all risk of defaults and worries no more exist. You just have to concentrate on the trade. So my friends, what I am going to convey is future contract is an upgraded version of the forward contract. So this is all about speculation through derivatives. I hope you have understood the meaning of bullish sentiments, bearish sentiments, bullish trend, bearish trend, and how to make the speculation through derivatives. Thank you so much. Have a nice time.